Well, you all right?
Oh, no. Don't even look at me.
I know, I can't. There's been tears today already.
Makeup, love me.
You okay?
I'm fine.
Yeah,
go on.
Gonna go on a smile?
Yeah.
Okay, well, we've got two of your all-time favourite guests joining us a little later. In the Loose Lounge, we've got two strapping chaps to help today's proceedings along. Oh, boys, pull yourself together. It's John Barrowman and Brian Connolly. Boys, pull yourselves together, seriously. I think you just blew a mic. And I'm sure that that didn't come out quite right either.
I'll see you later, boys.
Oops. The best of luck. Now, our first guest has achieved cult hero status playing Torchwood's Captain Jack Harness, the gun-toting, one-time indestructible agent who oversees the covert team of investigators who make it their business to explore the strange and unusual goings-on. Sound complicated? Well, trust me, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Warned you. Whoever these people are, they're good, and they're ready for us. Which puts us back at square one. We tackle FICOR ourselves.
And is that standard Torchwood policy?
Suppose it is, yeah.
You know, you dress like it's World War II, so I don't expect you to be up on current events. But there is no Torchwood. It's dead, gone, buried.
It's us.
As far as I can see, you got all your staff killed.
They were my friends.
Yeah, dead friends.
Rex, don't.
Please welcome John Barrowman.
Hello, ladies. Hello. Sorry, Jake.
Don't just say sorry to Jake. Ray's in the audience too.
Oh, sorry, Ray. Oh, sorry.
He doesn't care.
Oh, listen, don't let that stop you. She's never let her marriage get in the way of her.
It's really, really sad to see you go.
You.
But you're off to greener pastures and...
I don't know, to be honest.
Well, just tell everybody you are.
Many deals. Many deals with my grandkids.
Yeah.
Yes. Aww. I'm so glad you're here on my last show.
What was
show.
With you on this show that I started?
It was.
Really?
Was it?
Yeah.
And I tapped him.
Yeah. The things we got up to.
What do you mean you attacked him?
She attacked me. What I just did to her, she did to me.
Yeah.
Quit to marry your boyfriend.
Yeah, you turned me. Yeah. Never look back. Never look back.
Let's face it, if anyone was going to be able to turn you, she's got all the material.
Yeah, she does. Listen, I've always said, you know, gay men, you know, a lot of them like boobs.
Yeah.
You know, and that's they're a nice thing.
Right.
I'm going down.
The wrong road.
Just stop me now. Yeah. All right, I'm going down the wrong path. Yes. The point of no return. That's what makes everybody mama's boys.
Are you a mama's boy?
I am a mama's boy. Yeah,
really?
I am, but not in the sense that I go home and take my laundry or do all that kind of stuff. But I think it, you know, for me, my mother would always say it's important for a mother to nurture and to you know, raise the children, but also to let them fly the coop. Because if they do come home for dinners and laundry all the time, I think there might be something slightly wrong, off balance.
Mm-hmm. Well, you were outstanding on your own two feet from a young age, building a name for yourself.
Yes.
Did you fly the nest at an early age?
I left home I went out at 18. Yeah, I mean, I went away to school, and then I when I was off doing that, I started working and doing things, and my mom and, you know, my mother said when they went back to the house, when they saw me off to university for the first time and I got on the train to go to Southern California, she said they walked away and they were both gutted and devastated because they went back to the house. They really didn't know what to do, but let me tell you, they found a lot of things to do. Free time on their hands.
Now, you haven't got much of that these days because Torchwood just grows and grows, doesn't it? It started out as a little BBC Three show, then it went to BBC Two, and now it's a co-production shot partly in America for BBC One and the American network.
Correct. The Stars Network in the States and BBC One.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Yeah. I'm really, really proud of it. You know, there's been all this... There's been a little bit of controversy about it, you know, is it theirs, is it ours? And it's both. It's, you know, it's a joint ownership in a sense, but also the fact that I'm really proud because it started, it's a British iconic television show with a character that came from Doctor Who, and for us to take it to a foreign territory and make it a success, it's the best of British programming that we do good.
When it came from Doctor Who, did you ever think that it would turn into this massive?
I had no clue. I mean... I knew that I was being given a show that and you know, Eve Miles, who's my co-star in it, we felt really proud to be given that opportunity. Yeah. But no spin-offs from Doctor Who had ever worked. None of them had worked. And this was the first one. And it just skyrocketed. It took us by surprise. And I'm so proud of it. And I'm loving it. So thank
Captain
you to the
Jack,
audience.
Do you consider Captain Jack to be a superhero?
I do. He's a hero with a difference. And he's also a different kind of hero that, you know, he's unconventional. He doesn't have any... His only power, except in this series, he's the only mortal man on the planet because everybody else is immortal. I mean, Jack usually is the immortal one, so he's able to do anything to save humanity. But I do see him as a superhero. Mm. I think anybody who puts, you know, other people before themselves, that's a hero.
Mm. You're also busy on Saturday nights now with Tonight's the Night, which I absolutely love.
It's a brilliant
show. It's not...
Saturday, we're moving times this week. We're at 6:30 on Saturdays. But it's really nice to give back and do nice things for nice people. No, what are you laughing at? You've gone down that path, haven't you?
You've got a beautiful face. Oh. Sorry, I am interested in Saturday nights. I do watch it.
Honestly. I know you do.
Yeah, it is. It's brilliant.
But it's nice to do these nice things for good people because, you know, not everybody gets something nice to happen to them.
Exactly. No.
And the reaction that we have, you know, we've got a young girl coming up in a couple of weeks who sings with Andrea Bocelli. And I completely got overwhelmed. Mm. She sang and I couldn't speak as I came up to talk to her because I was completely... It struck me as John that how wonderful is this job that I have that
you
I'm
have
able
the opportunity to do it.
That was exactly it. And I couldn't... Even thinking about it now, I get funny about it, but it was absolutely brilliant. So there's all this stuff coming up. Saturday we've got...
Jimmy Savile without the trashy track suits and the jewellery.
That's me.
And finishing the year off with Panto with the Crankies,
which
I did absolutely.
They are brilliant. I have... The next book that I write, it's going to have a cranky chapter in it.
Well, John, please stick around and
I will.
Do raise a glass with us at the end of the show. Yes.
Definitely.
For Colleen. But thank you for coming today. John Barrowman, everyone. Time for another break, but we've still got plenty of surprises, Colleen. Stop. Yeah, we're back in a bit.
And I've seen
I absolutely love snogging.
But that's our Colleen, very upfront.
They are quite heavy to carry around, so it's always best to get someone else to carry them around for you.
I just want to put my head between them.
So, Colleen, from all of us, thanks for all the laughs.
Oh, my God, I can't even believe she said that. I'm beautiful in the way, just to make no mistakes. I'm on the right track, baby. I'm on the track, don't let it kill the regret. Just let it kill me instead. I'm like,
you're sucker.
Cock.
The only thing me and Shane absolutely argued over was the kids, and that's because he didn't want them and neither did I.
Hold up.
have got a sarcastic sense of humour.
Thank you very, very much.
You're welcome.
<That's> lovely.
Show is endless. We always head tomorrow. Four hungry voices with so much left to say. We were working on forever. It was good in every way. I can't believe we're gonna say goodbye today. My heart was captured the moment that I saw you. You are my future, and I couldn't turn away. When you held me and I trembled, I was sure that I would stay. I can't believe I'm gonna say goodbye today. It was all. It was almost right. It was all the things I dreamed of in the middle of the night. It was just beginning. It was everything and more. Are we gonna let a time like this slip right through our fingers? Slip right through our fingers. Stories, so many moments, a game we used to play. We were born to be together. Have we let it slip away? I can't believe I'm gonna say goodbye, lose it all for. Say goodbye today.